Now that we have the enterprise value of Whole Foods, we can go back to the market value balance sheet and fill in all the missing values. Here is the market value balance sheet as we had it before. Now, we enter 13,767 million for the enterprise value. Since the market value balance sheet balances, we can compute the value of equity by adding the enterprise value to the value of non-operating assets and subtracting debt. Doing this calculation leads to a value of equity of 13,842 million. To get the share price, we divide the value of equity by the number of shares outstanding, or 320 million. This results in a share price of 43.26. This is our final answer. The value we obtained is very close to the price paid by Amazon, justifying Evercore's comment that the deal was fairly priced.